What if I say I want to go on a trip? What would you do? You want to go on a trip? A mother asked. Well, I haven't really decided yet. Her father says, why all of a sudden? Isn't it a bit dangerous for a girl? It's a girl's intuition telling me. What is that? Mother says, it must be about Forte. You're gonna go anyway, even though we try to stop you, right? Yeah, I think so. We'll be worried, but as they say, if you love your child, let them go on a journey, right? Who says that? I never heard that. I think it's okay. The father says, hey, what are you saying? Una, you're as stubborn as your father, even though you don't look it. Honey, you're the one who's stubborn, even though you don't look it. No, you are. No, you are. Oh no, it's you. The father says, this is something I can't budge on. You're the stubborn one here. No, you are. I think you're both stubborn. Good night. The father says, honey, you're so stubborn. So are you. That's funny. Forte says, oh my, what should I do? McBain is snoring. A few days passed quickly while Forte and Una kept mulling it over, and the day of the Pinzel recital came. Okay. The host says, thank you for your enthusiastic performance. Dude, he's still playing. Unless this is the town music. Please wait in the waiting room. Guy looks mad. The next performer is Forte. He's from Reikos Palma, the town of Seabreeze. He'll play the Kithara. The title is I'm Fine. Bring it on. That's Forte, Una says. Forte's father says, go Forte! And his mother says, good luck. I'm nervous, as I expected. A jaunty jig. Good job, Una says. What an applause, Forte's mother says, and the father says he may be close to a win. The host says, thank you for your wonderful performance. I feel like I was given energy too. Please make yourself at home in the waiting room. Una says, well, there's gonna be one more performer, a violinist from Graysel. Mother says, then he's moments away from winning. I thought he is doing what he loves to. I didn't know he had it in him. Yep. After all, it's my son, says the father. McBain says, what are you saying? It's the product of my training. The mother says, usually both of you blame each other on Forte's weak points. They are such a pain. It's all because he's my son. Isn't that right, Una? Says Una. Let's welcome our last competitor. The next entry is Altos from the neighboring country across the ocean Graysel. And he's gonna, like, destroy the competition, I'm sure. He's going to play the violin. The title is Serenade of Wind. Please give him a round of applause. Alright, no one's applauding. Nope, no one cares. Altos, huh? We have applause now. Wow, he was pretty good, says Una. McBain says, he wasn't bad at all. His performance was like a night breeze whispering to the flowers and grass in a field. The host said, okay. It's unusual for a host to give an opinion like that. Now we are waiting for the results of the judges. We've heard from all the participants. At this moment, Great Rung as well as Ambassador Bios from Graysel, also Ambassador Gareno from Kingdom of Burrodane, are judging our contestants. Please wait a little while for the results to come in. Who was that? Someone ran up. Does he have the results? I've just received the results. Who will the Goddess of Music smile upon? Contestants, please come up to the stage one more time. Welcome again, our contestants. Interesting band. This recital in Pinzel is held only once every 4 years. Not only does the winner get the honor, but also the top two will be qualified to participate in the international recital. The international recital is to be held next year in the Cavaro International Theater in the art city of Marcherose. I predict this Altos will be the top winner, and Forte will be the second place. This way he gets to go to the international recital and try to defeat Altos again at that recital. Altos is set up to be not the antagonist, maybe, but I keep starting to say Aven. Forte's the word I'm trying to think of, competitor, like his rival, right? I think that Altos would be his rival. Now I'm going to read the names of the winners. The third prize goes to Miss Pepeka, who played the ocarina. Congratulations. I can't believe this, she says. The second prize goes to Forte from Reikos Palma. So far I'm correct. Congratulations. Way to go, Forte, says Una. The grand prize goes to Altos from Graysel. I called it, guys. Playing blind. Never played this before. Don't know how it goes. But, yeah, that was pretty predictable. The judges said they were so charmed with the sound of his violin. Mr. Altos, Mr. Forte, please take a step forward. Well, the judges might have been swayed by what you said on stage, which is you're giving an opinion and you're supposed to be impartial. The judges are the ones who be, partial. Those two are qualified to participate in the international recital to be held in the Cavaro International Theater. Congratulations. Yeah, Forte, good job, says Una. You're awesome, Forte, she says. You're worthy of receiving the second prize. Yeah, thanks. What's wrong, Forte? You don't look that excited. Well, he won in first place, of course. Forte's father says, the second prize is very good. You should be happy. I know. Grandpa, are you really going on a tour? Yeah, since I've got a map, my dream is about to become a reality. I'm going to get ready as soon as possible once returning to the village. I'm going to come with you. What? Una's like, The mother says, Forte, what did you just say? You're the one who told... Like, maybe they're acting like it wasn't their idea. I'm coming with you! Are you going to go on a tour with me? Yes, that's right. I've come to realize that I want to try music seriously, so I'll come with you. I want to become a performer who will still be loved by many people like you. That's my boy, Forte, his father says. Una says, wait a minute. but I'm not sure how he really feels about me. He's gonna leave for a tour with Grandpa Mac? They don't even know when they're coming back. Oh, wait. What? Says Forte. Then... I'll come with you too! Why you, Una? Says Forte. McBean says, it's okay, if you really want to. Grandpa, are you sure? McBean says, but the training is not easy. We'll start practicing immediately upon returning to the village. As long as you join the company, you have to perform decently, or I feel bad for the audience. He's already determined, Forte says. Forte's father says, but Una, you have to consult with your parents. That's right, says Forte. Let's get busy, Jan, McBean says. Arf! Jan's sleeping. That's your sleepy doggy. Aw. That butterfly is almost as big as he is. You go get him. Go get him, Jan. Oh, they're playing together. Awesome. Just like a troop of troubadours. Yeah, this is gonna be a three-parter. Obviously. Because right now you're probably watching part 3 of 3. McBean says, good. That wasn't bad. Well, it was good, so that... good is not bad. Traveler's Prelude will be the first entry in our repertoire. The first piece we can play with the three of us. Now that we've heralded our own departure, might as well get going, shall we? Forte says, he's not known as a great performer for nothing. He's practicing even on the morning of our departure. Una says, yeah, but I want to put on a good performance that the audience will enjoy. You just said a good thing, McBean says. Una says, you haven't forgotten anything? I don't care about anything else as long as we have the book on the water melody and the magic map. McBean checked the inside of his pocket. Good. I have them right in here. That means you're going to lose them soon. Are you sure? Says Forte. Why do you ask? It's because I saw the book on the table when I left our house. What? Then what do I have in here? McBean took out a book titled Searching for the Unknown Fishing Spot. Forte says, I'm worried about our future trip. Here's your book. Forte holds out the Book of Water Melody. I was just testing you to see if you would notice. Una says, hey, it's going to be a fun trip. It's time to go, McBean says. The people must be gathering at the exit of the village to see us off. Forte says, Jan. Woof. He said, let's go, Jan, and Jan really started going. Grandpa, you didn't fix the rope after all, did you? My dad was mad. He's a man of low caliber to get mad at such a small matter. He'd talk about his own son like that. Burned. I don't know why I'm going this way, just to see if there's anything to be seen. I know this is the way to the lighthouse. I am well aware, thank you. We can go up here, in here, but I don't think we're gonna find anything on top. I just wanna see if, you know, I don't know. I wanna go as far as the door and that's it. Whoop. Whoop. Alright, so now we check in with everybody. Well, they're gathered at the exit / entrance. But let's see if there's anyone in any of these houses. Exchange. Wow. I'm buying a couple more Cure Bottle S's. Oh, he said thank you? Huh. Yeah, there's no one in here. This is where the two old people live, right? Hmm. We could rip everyone off! Steal from them first. Alright, yeah, everyone's left everything. His parents' house is this way. Oh, we get a rest? Yes, please. So they're all waiting at the entrance and we go, like, lay down for 8 hours. Why do you sleep on your stomach? Because it's comfortable. Why the hell not? Oh, can we walk? No. I've tried that before. And it never worked. Yet somehow I feel like it's going to work. This time. Wow. Look at all those peoples. I still think your grandpa is cool, Forte. He says. Please become a musician who is greater than Mr. McBean. You can do it, Forte. I don't think McBean wants us to be better than him. Forte, Regal told me about you. I also decided to help research on creating colors by mixing dye and petals of flowers. I will have created more colors by the time you will come back here. I can't wait to see them. I look forward to it. If you get in a bind during your tour, go consult with older people. There are no other people you can rely on more than older people. I will, Forte says. My grandpa is not reliable anyway. Did you say something? McBean says. Yep, he said something. Both Bot and Kel said they will help me do research on dyes. I can't wait to produce more colors. I'm looking forward to it, Forte says. Be careful. Take care of yourself and have a fun trip. Thanks, says Forte. You guys are lucky, Una, Forte, because you're members of the McBean Company. I talked to this person, right? Isn't that Regal or something? Bot. Bote. Una is sometimes stubborn, but she's a nice girl. Forte, take care of Una, alright? Or just ignore him. Forte, watch over Una. Grandpa Mac, thank you for everything. McBean says, don't worry about anything since I'm with them. That's what I'm supposed to say, Grandpa. Una, take care of yourself. Good luck. Bye. Forte, keep an eye on Grandpa so that he won't go anywhere dangerous. Okay, I will. Wish they'd worry about me just a little. Forte, take good care of Grandpa. Yes, I'll keep an eye on him. I get the feeling they want us to watch over him. Not being able to see them is like not having any snacks at 3 o'clock. I feel like something is missing. See who? What you talking about, Kale? You guys will make good company in every single aspect. Please tell me about your adventure when you're back. Don't give Mac a hard time. Una, good luck. Una says, thanks, Grandma Shella. Goodbye. McBain says, my fellow villagers, thank you for gathering here to send us off. Today, after 10 years of silence, the new McBain Company is leaving for a world tour. Cool, says Bot. Kel says, fabulous. There was a time long ago that I was spending my days as a troubadour. And again, words are not adequate to describe how happy I am to depart on this beautiful day. I'll keep your kindness in my heart and... Grandpa, keep your speech short, please. I agree, says Una. It gives a better impression. Instead of making a speech about our departure, I would like to play you a musical piece. Traveler's Prelude, The McBain Company. Well, we have a name for the group, The McBain Company. Was always right, Avon and Friends, Avon and Pals, Avon and Company. It's the McBain Company. Good, says Bot. Reggle says, bravo. McBain says, goodbye now. Be careful, says Reggle.
I'm looking forward to hearing your stories from your trip, says Grandpa Rito.
Forte says, sure thing. Bye. Goodbye, says Una. Forte, Una, Jan, McBain says, we are off now. Una says, Grandpa Mac, what's our plan now? Well, we have to get our passport reissued by Great Rung in Pinzel. Passport is like an ID to prove which country you're from. And then, we need to get our visa stamps at the embassies of Graysol and Burrowdean. When you cross the border of countries, you need to take an immigration procedure in advance. You can't enter the countries without a passport. Well, let's get going. Alright. Let me just head back to the town. We'll go that far. Kill this thing. We are the killer of monkeys and armadillons. Ah. Nice. You're killing those armadillons more quicker now. Let's see if we can steal an item from the armadillo. Steal failed. Nah. There we go. Get back here. Oh. Yeah, I need to have him use his power. Maybe I should wait for an armadillo. Oh, we have another one. Jan, ready to use his power as well. One. I know that's a waste to use a finishing move on these little monkeys. That's why we're not using it. Then we all got full meters now. Oop. Rock crash. Wow, 260. Yeah, I'm trying to decide if I wanna. Yeah, I'm gonna not use the finishing moves on this thing. Well, this should be the end, I think, of running back and forth between Kranka and Reiko's Palma. I'm hoping there's not as much backtracking as in A Tear of Vermilion. It's always like, we gotta run back to, I forget the name of these places. Boren or New Boren. We gotta run back there again. Yeah, that was getting kinda old. It's kind of a waste. There's only one enemy to be affected. Ooh, got a purify potion. How many of those do we have now? Because we used one of them, right? I think we have 9 again. I remember hearing this part. We got 10 now, wow. So if this is anything like the first two games, we won't be able to collect any more. Which is fine, because we also have the Purification Stone. Chan bites back. Okay, so I'm gonna stop off here. I'm not completely sure if the village is the next screen. But just in case it is, I have a feeling we might get caught into a cutscene, and I kind of want to call in an episode here so we can start anew with the next video. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.